You're watching First Electric Ride, and this is the Hyundai Ioniq, the best car in the world. I was convinced this was the best electric vehicle, but there's one but. We bought this car at the lowest market price for $12,000. It has some minor paint damage on the right side, but no other issues. The battery is rated at 97% state of health. Before buying, we ran all the diagnostics, even went to an official dealer. Everything checked out fine, no errors. But then, we ran into a problem. At 50 kilometers per hour with a 12% charge, the car just stopped and went into turtle mode. Power dropped to zero, and the car wouldn't move. I've shown this before, but I'll replay it for those who missed it. At 12% charge, the system displayed a low power warning, and the car just stopped. Here's what it looked like. I start the car, switch to drive, and nothing. No available tow trucks, but there is a taxi with a tow strap. I still believe the Ioniq 28 is a great electric car. Under normal conditions, its range is about 150 to 200 kilometers. I want to repeat this test. The car is currently at 30% charge, and I'll discharge it to 12% again to check for cell imbalance. They say you need to check this exactly when the car can't drive anymore. But here's what I'm curious about. I always thought that if one cell drops, the car would immediately show 0% and stop. In my case, it still showed a remaining range of 20 to 30 kilometers and gradually reduced the charge. 12%, 11%, 10%. So I'll check the cell imbalance at 30% charge. Let me know what you think in the comments. I don't think we'll be able to cover all the issues with this car in just one video, even though we probably just got unlucky with this particular unit. I still consider it the best EV under $15,000. First, the price. Second, fast charging at up to 60 kilowatts, and overall, these cars come well equipped. This one, for example, is fully loaded except for the sunroof, has all the driver assists, heated seats, even ventilation. Right now, the battery is at 31%. I plan to check the voltage and cell imbalance using an ELM device and car scanner. Connected, selected the profile, choosing all sensors, reading the data. As you can see, the minimum unbalance is 0.02. The lowest cell is at 3.5 volts, the highest at 3.52 volts. I've already consulted experts, and they say these are great numbers. But let's see if anything changes when we discharge to 0%. Okay, here we go. Actually, not to 0%, but until it stops. Let's go. At a red light, 18% charge, estimated range, 29 kilometers. Check car scanner. Highest cell at 3.42 volts, lowest at 3.28 volts. I think we're about to get a surprise. 16% charge. Highest cell, 3.4 volts, lowest, 3.18 volts. It's about to stop, 14%. Turned off the AC since I still have a long way to go to the charger and switch to eco mode, but I think we'll stop soon. Car scanner confirms it. 3.36 volts versus 3.06 volts. That's quite a gap. Stopping. Okay, 3.38 volts versus 3.06 volts. Here's what the cell data looks like. If you know about this, let me know in the comments. I think this is significant. 13% charge, estimated range, 23 kilometers. Interesting. Now, let's crawl a little closer to the charging station. Oh, battery depleted, 13%. You see it yourself. Push. But we're still moving. 13%. We're moving. Okay, turn the AC back on at 30%. 13%. Difference between cells. Still showing 3.38 volts. Oh, 2.90 volts. All right, floor it up. A small decline, 12%. Well, we're still going. Turning around. Well, guys, so far so good. Even the AC is still working. Turning it down. Floor it. Oh, power is limited, but we're still moving. That's it. But last time it stopped immediately. Okay, 12%, that's how it should be. Well, let's discharge it further. 11%, still going, turning around. I don't really want to leave the charger because last time it cost 600 hryvnias. It won't go faster than 30 kilometers per hour. All right, 10%. Pedal to the floor. And I think that's it. It stopped by itself. That's it. We're not going anywhere. Look, 10%, and I can still drive 15 kilometers. Let's check our scanner. Let's see what's going on. One cell has dropped, 2.6 volts. That's very low. That's why it stopped us. Well, the situation isn't great. There's still some distance to the charging station, but I have an idea. You'll see now. Let's try turning the car off. Last time the car barely made it to the WOG gas station. It started. All right, let's go. The battery is dead, but we're moving. That's it. Goodbye. This is how it was last time, and you can do it a few times, but each time the range decreases by 5 to 7 meters. Last time I called a tow truck that never showed up, then a taxi service arrived. But this time I have another idea, you will see. All right, let's open the charging port. Friends, I brought the EcoFlow and my charger Svartex with me, turning on the EcoFlow. See that? Svartex is powering up. I think in about half an hour, we'll have enough charge to drive. We do this little trick and plug in the charger. Let's see if the charging session has started. Yeah, the car is charging. Friends, what do you think about this life hack? I think I'll increase the power to 2 kilowatts. That's the EcoFlow limit. And then I'll get to the nearest charging station at WOG and sort things out from there. I'll even try to raise it to 9 amps. And with this setup, I can even step away for a bit. Maybe if I slow charge for another 20 minutes, I'll add at least 10 to 15%, or maybe just 2 to 3%, well, 5%, and then I'll move on. Leave a comment below on what I should do next with this car, although I already know for sure that we will put it on slow charging today. Maybe after charging at 7 amps, the battery will recalibrate and we can repeat this experiment. We've only gained 1% in 15 minutes, but I need at least 2% more. I left home with 89%. Now it's 63%. I hope to gain a few more percent and then I will move on. Meanwhile, the imbalance is decreasing, 3.42 volts versus 3.18 volts. But the situation isn't great. I only have 11% charge when I need at least 12%. Less than 1 kilometer left to the WOG station. At this moment, the car has 11% charge. The EcoFlow has 32% left, and I still don't see 12% on the dashboard. This is most likely due to uneven cell discharge. Well, friends, I still have 11%. Let me show you. By the way, EcoFlow has already died. I'll try to drive. The crucial moment of the experiment. Starting the car. Okay, drive mode. Let's go, baby. Charging is free, WOG filling station. Today we refuel and charge here. We have 11%, but the main thing is that we did it. Now I'm sure everything will be fine. The charging station is 60 kilowatt. That's quite enough for the city considering my car. My plan is to put the car on slow charging, bring it up to 10 to 15% and get home. Then set it to 7 amps. This will calibrate the battery. We have all the calibration data, so we'll see how it works. For now, I'll set up the charge. Well, while I'm having lunch, because I'm a bit cold, I'll try some potato pancakes. I was recommended these, but haven't tasted them yet. When we filmed 18 cars here, some of our colleagues had dinner and said this is a must-have. Next, let's move to my home. Ioniq is on charge. Set to 7 amps, a full charge will take about 18 to 19 hours. We'll repeat the experiment tomorrow. Drop a comment with your thought thoughts. What's in store for us tomorrow? The car has been sitting for almost a day. Now we have 100% battery charge. The estimated range is 207 kilometers. Regarding degradation, 96.9% SOHH. The cell imbalance is 0.2 volts. Interestingly, BMS shows 95% battery charge level. I don't really want to hit the highway with this charge level, so I'll try to discharge the battery around Kyiv. I'm not sure if this will work, but let's try. You saw that the display showed 0 degrees Celsius, but it's actually -5 degrees Celsius outside. This is me just driving out of a warm parking lot where the temperature is about 0 degrees Celsius. Yesterday, I rode 95 kilometers. Now I have 30% charge left. Let me show you with EcoFlow. Why is there 30% of the charge left considering I only drove 95 kilometers? Yes, I drove very aggressively, warmed up the car multiple times. I put extra loads on it, so it's too early to say the battery is dead. I think under normal conditions, the car would have gone 150 to 160 kilometers, but still, we do see some battery degradation. I'm sure the passive balancing process went through. Not sure how much it will help. I think in an hour, everything will be clear. Right now, it's 30%. There is an imbalance between the cells again, 0.02. Here are the readings. Maximum cell, 3.52 volts, minimum 3.5 volts. Took a screenshot, check for yourself. Let's move on, and you know what I think. If I stop somewhere between 5% and 7%, maybe the balancing will be more effective. I'll do a few of these cycles. For example, I'll leave the car for 3 days. If the level is again at 9, 10, or 11%, I'm definitely going to the master service center. I've already made arrangements in advance. Everything is set. You'll get interesting content. How batteries are repaired in Ukraine. All right, let's continue. Next update will be at the finish line. Battery is at 20%, so I decided to check the cells. The variations aren't critical. 0.4 minus 0.2. Moving on. By 13%, the system reported a low battery, just like last time. Some small energy losses, but we're still moving. It even accelerates, and there's no power limitation. We're still driving fine. Friends, 10%. No turtle mode. I push the pedal to the floor while the car accelerates normally. Probably some minor improvements. At 10%, the estimated range shows only 13 kilometers, but now it's already at 9%. I wish the display was more accurate so I wouldn't end up stopping at 10% and suddenly that's it, game over. 9%, 12 kilometers of range. All right, the first underpowering, but the car hasn't shut off. At 5%, the first turtle mode appeared, but we're still moving. At 3%, the car is still driving and even accelerating. Just in case, I turned off the climate control to stretch the range as far as possible. Thing is, I don't want to use EcoFlow today. All right, we're still rolling. Another power limitation warning. Let's park the car. At 3%, I want to check the cell balance with car scanner. There's a slight imbalance, 3.38 volts versus 3.08 volts, but it's not as bad as last time. Down to 2%, another warning. But the car is still running. We are at WOG again, and I still have power. I won't discharge it to zero this time. This is enough for me. Now let's plug in and draw some conclusions. I parked at 2% charge. Here, look. See that? The range estimate shows dashes. But the car is still moving. See for yourself. I'm maneuvering mode, up to 40 kilometers per hour. It still moves. Didn't lose power like our black Ioniq did. Now, car scanner, highest cell, 3.36 volts, lowest, 3.04 volts. There's an imbalance, but not as bad as before. I'll consult with experts. This experiment shows that frequent fast charging definitely causes battery imbalance. Even though I only drove 120 kilometers, it was due to the maximum acceleration. And that is improper usage. What's next? The service center and some consulting. But for now, I won't do anything. Right now, 3.36 volts versus 3.04 volts. You know, friends, I need to go through all the cells and record the data. The battery needs passive balancing or calibration? Let me know in the comments below. Our Ioniq is still alive. I think we need to repeat this test a few more times, charge the battery slowly, maybe at 1 kilowatt or even 0.5 kilowatt, and continue to investigate. The car made it. You saw everything. As always, hit the like button, leave comments. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.